Morning, I love you. So welcome back to online webinar classes. Today we are going to be discussing about mammalian reproductive system, animal biotechnology. So Vinpistunda Shankara, Shiva Shankar, Vinpistunda?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So today, welcome back to online webinar classes. This is Krishna, sir. Today we are going to be discussing about mammalian reproductive system and gametogenesis. Okay, so that is this anatomy of physiology and animal reproductive system. That is, first, before we are going to that, terms of reproductive system, what is that? Alimentary canal, what is bladder, what is cervix, what is clitoris, what is cloaca, what is copulation, what is Cowper glands, what is epididymis? Okay. What is fallopian tubes? What is funnel? Okay. What is infundibulum? What is gamete? What is gestation period? What is isthmus? Labia majora, labia minora, magnum, mucosal cells, and ova. Ovary ducts. These are the terms we are going to. Terms continued. What is papilla? What is parturition? Penis, prostate glands, retractor muscles, scrotum, semen, seminal vesicles, sigmoid flexure, spermatozoa, testicles, testosterone, urethra, urine, uterine hormones, uterus, vagina, vasa deferens, and vulva, zygote. So mainly, what are the major reproductive organs in male bodies? What are the functions of those organs? Okay. So, and reproductive system of male organs, that is, mainly, what are the importance is there? In which condition they are going to mature? The organs are going to mature, especially for to have a successful livestock operation. A producer must have understanding the functions of these various reproductive organs are there. Okay. Okay, just a network problem. The male reproductive system contains several interconnected parts that must be all working together in order to have successful mating. Some of the major organs found in male mammalian reproductive system are, that is, male reproductive system. Number one, testicles are there. వినిపిస్తున్నామా? వినిపిస్తున్నా? Okay, let us, the mail reproductive system contains several interconnected reproductive systems are there. What are the mail reproductive system? That is, okay, that is number one, testicles are there. These testicles to produce a sperm, the male produces sperm. So the male sex cells are called spermatozoa. They also produce a hormone called testosterone that causes, okay, that causes the appearance and the behavior of the animals to be masculine. For example, the testicle, the testicles which are produces testosterone, so this testosterone to maintain the behavior of the masculine. There are the two testicles present in the, two testes are present in the male mammals. Okay, so male reproductive system, that is, okay, number one, epididymis. Okay, so that is epididymis. Epididymis is the storage site for sperm cells. These cells enter the epididymis from the testes to mature. So this epididymis, which is a storage of the sperm cells, these cells are present in the epididymis. So this group of the testicles, seminiferous vesicles, to made up of epididymis is there. This particularly this testes to mature from the epididymis, the sperm become able to fertilize female ova. This sperm, which is to fertilize after maturity, this sperm to fuse with ova to form of zygote, or fuse or fertilize with the female sex called as it travel through the epididymis. There is a separate epididymis attached to each testis. Each testis or testicle. Okay, so that is the testis are primary reproductive organ of the bulb. You know very well. See the diagram, and the testis primary reproductive organ of the bulb. So vasa difference. So epididymis, the body of the epididymis, head of the epididymis. So from the epididymis, what happened? From the epididymis. Okay. So to collect the sperm through the vasa afferentia. Vasa differentia is also there. In this epididymis, which contains so many seminiferous tubules are there. What ma? Seminiferous tubules are there, in so many seminiferous tubules which are present in this epididymis. This epididymis, which contains seminiferous tubules, the seminiferous tubules to secrete the sperm. This sperm enters into vasa afferentia and vasa differentia also there. So next, the male reproductive system, scrotum. What is scrotum? Scrotum is a, what ma? The scrotum is a two-lobed sac. What ma? Two-lobed sac that contains, protect the two testicles are there. Two testicles. So the scrotum looking like a two-lobed sac-like structure, which contains the two testes. It is also to regulate. It is also to regulate the temperature of the testicles and maintaining them at the temperature lower than the body temperature. The scrotum, which contains a low temperature, so which maintains a temperature lower than the body temperature also. This is when, so when the environmental temperature is low, when the environmental temperature is low, the scrotum contracts. When the environmental temperature is high, the scrotum is relaxed. Remember one thing. When the environmental temperature is low, very low, in that the case, okay, the scrotum should be contract. When the environmental temperature is high, the scrotum relaxes. That is a very important thing. Then maintaining the correct temperature is critical in the being to be a hot or too cold can affect the production and vitality of the sperm or mobility of the sperm. So for example, the temperature is the critical temperature is there. This critical temperature, what happened, ma? It will be affect to the sperm. It will be affect to the sperm and what, ma? What we can call it? So mobility of the sperm also. That is also one of the effect. It will be takes place, right? Next, vasa differentia. What is what, ma? Vasa differentia. This vasa difference is okay. Is essential. This vasa differentia is essential. The transportation of the tube that carries the sperm containing fluid from each epididymis to urethra. So this vasa differentia, what this vasa differentia function? This vasa differentia function, remembering one thing, it collect the so sperm from the epididymis, looking like a tube like structure, okay, to send to the urethra. So that is one of the important aspects, vasa differentia. So in this vasa differentia, we are going to observe in, so diagram C. So this is the epididymis, the U-shaped, that means like kidney-shaped one, that is epididymis is there. This vasa differentia also there. Vasa differentia also. This vasa differentia to collect the spermatozoa from epididymis seminiferous vesicle to vasa differentia. This vasa differentia to collect the sperm and send to the urethra. Okay. So that is one of the important. And now next one, urethra. So this urethra, the urethra is a large muscular. Urethra is a what, ma? Large muscular canal extending from the urinary bladder. Okay. Urethra is a large muscular canal extending from the urinary bladder. Both the semen and urine move through the urethra to end up the penis. Okay. So this is one of the important about the reproductive system. And next one, accessory sex glands. What is that, ma? Accessory sex glands are there. So what are the accessory sex glands are there, right? So these accessory sex glands, okay, there are several glands that add volume and nutrition to the sperm. This accessory gland to secrete the, what happened, ma? Looking like a semen, it is a nutrient fluid to the sperm, a rich fluid coming from the epididymis. Okay, now these accessory glands, which is the accessory fluids to send to epididymis, the epididymis sperm, okay, which is to viability and it will be mobility under the you know very well the influence of these accessory glands fluid. Okay, and next one, seminiferous vesicle, the seminal vesicles. What are the seminal vesicles are there? These seminal vesicles, what is that, ma? The seminal vesicles open into the urethra. What is that, ma? The seminal vesicles, okay, so open into urethra, they produce a fluid that protect transport the sperm. Seminal vesicles, what, ma? The seminal vesicles open into urethra, they produce a fluid that protect the transport the sperm. Okay. So this is one of the important seminal vesicles. And what are the prostate gland? This prostate gland is a near the prostate gland, what, ma? This prostate gland is near the urethra and the bladder. It is near the urethra and bladder to produce a, what is that, ma? It produces a fluid that mixed with the seminal fluid. These prostate gland also to be near, it is present near of the urethra and the bladder. It produces something fluid and mixed with the seminal fluid. Seminal fluid also, right? This is the one of the important. Next one, Kaufer glands. What is it, ma? Kaufer glands. So this Kaufer glands produces fluid. The Kaufer glands also to produce one of the fluid. So this fluid, okay, so that moves down the urethra. it moves what ma? It moves down the what ma? Urethra. So it moves down the urethra ahead of the seminal fluid. This fluid cleans. This fluid what ma? This fluid clean and sterilize and help the protect of the sperm. Okay. So this coffer gland fluid is one of the important fluid. What happened ma? The fluid to clean the seminal fluid and neutralize it helps the it helps the protect the sperm through the urethra also. The mixture of the seminal and prostate fluid, the sperm is called what ma? Semen. Okay, so this is very very important. Remembering one thing, the seminal fluid and prostate fluid, seminal fluid and prostate fluid is mixed to be form of what happened ma? Seminal fluid, the seminal and prostate fluid. And the sperm is called what ma? Semen. What is semen? Nothing but seminal fluid, that is which contains sperm, and prostate fluid which is to form of semen. Okay, so the semen which contains what? The semen which contains remembering one thing, the semen which contains that means what ma? Sperm and seminal fluid, the prostate fluid also, right? Okay, next one, penis. What is that ma? Penis also there. This penis deposits the semen within the female reproductive system. The penis, what happened ma, it is look like a rod like structure. The penis deposits the semen within the female reproductive system. The urethra in the penis is surrounded by a spongy tissue. Urethra the penis, what ma, is surrounded by a spongy tissue that fills with the blood when the male is sexually aroused. But ma, so that is what the tissue which is filled with the blood, in that condition the male should be, he is there, in that condition the male should be excited. This causes erection, that is a necessary copulation. So in that the case, what happened ma, the sperm that male should be want to mate with female. So that is copulation or mating to occur. So this is one very important thing. Okay, the sigmoid flexure is there here. What is it, ma? Sigmoid flexure. What is sigmoid flexure? The sigmoid flexure, remember one thing, this sigmoid flexure found in bulls. The sigmoid flexure, ma, found in bulls, rams, boars. So whereas in man it should not there. And the retractor muscle, what is it, ma? The retractor muscle extend the penis from the sheath, the tubular fold of skin. Horses, other mammals do not have the sigmoid flexure. Okay, na? So what is that, ma? The sheath, these retractor muscle extend the penis from the sheath, the tubular fold of the skin. Horses and other mammals do not have. Okay, the blood that fills the spongy tissue when the sexual arousal occurs cause erection. Okay. When the blood is to be reached to the sperm tissue in the penis, it should be compulsory. The male should be required. Male should be want to mate with the female. Okay, so that is what a very important thing. Okay, in this male reproductive general, what is that, ma? See, in the male, what are the important aspects are there, right? Here, see. See what happened, ma? Here in the diagram, penis is there for the copulation. This one is urethra. The pass of urethra, the pass passage of urine and the sperm. Copper glands, the copper glands are there. Secretion may lubricate, flush out urine and to form of a gelatinous plug. Okay, and prostate gland, this prostate gland secrete the alkaline solution to neutralize urine and female system. The seminal vesicles, they secrete the thick liquid transport sperm. Okay, and epididymis, what is that? Epididymis, the transport, the transport and maturation of the ejaculation and organ, that is mainly testes and seminiferous tubules, which is responsible for the sperm production. So these are the organs, male organs and function. One is testes, collecting ducts, epididymis, okay, vasa differentia, and seminiferous vesicles, prostate gland, and penis also. These are the male reproductive system and its functions. Okay, and reproductive organ of bull. Okay, this is the reproductive organ of the bull. We are observing the diagram. So here, really network problem. So in this reproductive system of the bull, what is we can observe, ma? So in this scrotum, here the scrotum is present. In the scrotum, already told you, in the scrotum which is responsible for the temperature is low, it should be contracted. When the temperature is medium, it should be expansion takes place. The scrotum which contains two testes are there, testicles are there. The testicles which contain seminiferous vesicles are there. Okay, this part is called epididymis. Scrotum, which is present in the epididymis, right? In this epididymis, what happened? The sperm which is there in the tube-like structure, vasa deferens. Vasa differentia is there. Vasa differentia. Okay, this vasa differentia, which is vasa afferentia is there, and prostate glands are there, coffer glands are there. Okay, so these are the important, and seminiferous vesicles are there, and penis also there. What is that, ma? Penis also there. This penis, which is responsible for which is open into urethra, which is open into outside. So this penis, which is having one rod like structure, which is ejaculation of the sperm also. This is what male reproductive system. And see, we already observed what are the parts are there in the epididymis in the bull diagram. So see, in the epididymis, scrotum, testes, okay, head of the epididymis, spermatic cord, okay, seminiferous blood vessels, vasa deferens, urinary bladder, ampulla, seminiferous vesicles, and what is the sigmoid flexure is there. So sigmoid flexure, that is only a bull which is have there, the sigmoid flexure. But whereas in man, horse should not there, right? These sigmoid flexure, which is open into glands, penis, is the sheath also there, and penis, glands, penis is there. This is the overall structure of this bull. And male reproductive system of the ram, reproductive system of the ram. So this ram should not have the sigmoid flexure is not there. What is that, ma? Sigmoid flexure is not the same, remaining also same, and sheath is not there. Okay, this is epididymis, scrotum, testes, vasa differentia, vasa afferentia, prostate glands, ampulla, everything is there, bladder is there, right? And sigmoid flexure is absent, whereas in male ram. And male reproduction in buck also, reproduction of buck. See here, what is the parts are there? Here epididymis, scrotum, testicles are there. Okay, vasa differentia. Okay, bladder is there, a copper gland, sigmoid flexure also there in buck, urethra, and same whereas we discussed in bull, same, and penis, urethral process, and propuse also present. This is a diagram of buck. So what are the major reproductive organs and functions of the female in mammals, like like males and females, mammals have a complex system of the organs, okay, that make up the reproductive system. Some of the major organs that make up the female reproductive tract are there. What are the tract is there, right? So the female reproductive system, now we are going to see female reproductive system. So this female reproductive system, especially for a ovary, number one, what, ma? Ovary is there. This ovary, the ovary produces female gametes, but ma, ova should be produced from the ovary, right? A gamete is a sex cell. What is that, ma? A gamete is a sex cell that can unite the with other sex cells. These are called ORX. Okay, so this ovary to produce something, what, ma? The pair of unit one cell is there, that is called a gamete. It is also called ovary egg. A female mammal, while typically have two ovaries are there. What, ma? Typically two ovaries are there, left side, left, right side also there. The ovaries also produce, what is, ma? The ovaries also produce the female sex hormones, estrogen, progesterone. Whereas in already told you, testes to produce testosterone in the influence of FSH and LH. Here also from the ovaries, estrogen, progesterone also produces, I think earlier classes we already discussed in endocrinology, right? With each ovary, what is it, ma? Each ovary, there are hundreds of, the teeny follicles or cavities are there. The ova produced the follicles, the largest single cell in the body. Huge number of follicles, primary follicles, secondary follicles are there in these ovaries. Then primary follicle to convert into secondary follicle to convert it to finally, ova should be produced. So, right, ovaries completed. Now, let us come to the point of female reproductive system. And next point, that is second organ. That is what is, ma? Oviducts. What is that, ma? That is called what, ma? Oviduct. Oviduct, or it is also known as fallopian tube. It is also known as what, ma? Fallopian tube, right? So the oviduct or fallopian tubes are two tubes that carry ova from the ovaries to uterus. For example, left side, right side ovaries are there. These ovaries to connected with the fallopian tube. These fallopian tube collect the ova from the ovaries. So, and to send to uterus, the oviduct are close but not attached to the ovaries. These ovaries are close, of course, close to ovaries, but should not attach the ovaries, right? It should be, which is having flagellated particles are there. These flagellated particles movement are takes place. In that case, what happened, ma? So that sperm to collect with the help of that movement. So, right. Next one, what is it, ma? The funnel shaped end of the, what is it, ma? The funnel shaped end of the each oviduct that is close to the ovary, okay, is called the infundibulum. The funnel shaped, what, ma? And each oviduct that is looking like a this funnel shape oviduct which contains like cilia, that is called infundibulum. At the ovulation the follicles are raptured, releasing an ovum that caught by the infundibulum. So raptured of egg from the ovaries, that should be in the ovulation process, that should be captured by this infundibulum with the help of the funnel, right? That is one of the important oviduct. After copulation, what is that, ma? After copulation, the sperm, after copulation, after fusing, the sperm move through the uterus to the oviduct, and fertilization of the ovum occurs in the upper and end of the oviduct. Actually, the fertilization takes place in the oviduct. Remembering one thing, the fertilization takes place in where, ma? Oviduct. So that's why internal fertilization takes place in the mammals, like to be form of zygote or fertilized egg cell. Zygote is called what, ma? Fertilized egg. This fertilized egg cell moves to the uterus about 2 to 4 days. This after fertilization, the zygote to move to uterus after 2 to 4 days after fertilization. Okay, so that is important thing. Next, female reproductive system. What is that, ma? Female reproductive system, that is uterus number 3 part, ovary completed, oviduct completed. Next to, we are going to what, ma? Uterus. The uterus of the mammal is Y-shaped. What, ma? Is Y-shaped. Remembering one thing. So Y-shaped structure consisting of the body, the uterine horns are there, and the cervix are there. The size and shape of the uterus, size and shape of the uterus varies among the various species. The different species having different size of the uterus is there. The upper part of the uterus consists of uterine horns are there. Uterine horns are there. The development in the oviduct, fallopian tubes is there. The most species pregnancy normally occurs in the uterine horns. Uterine horns are there. In horses, pregnancy in horses, pregnancy normally occurs in the body of the uterus. Okay. But there are different mammals, other mammals other than ours, okay. This fertilization takes place in the uterine suckers. Whereas in different, that means horses, the fertilization takes place in the pregnancy takes place in the horses. The horses pregnancy normally occurs in the body of the uterus. In all species, foetus grow within the uterus where it remains the parturition or birth. Parturition means delivering the baby to outside. That is called parturition or birth. Okay, so during the, this is called gestation period. Okay, the total the baby should be present in till the fertilization takes place, till the end of the delivery, till end of the delivery. So the uterus should be carried, right? This is what very important. Next, what is cervix is the cervix, the next one, the cervix is the lower outlet. Cervix is the lower outlet of the uterus. It is composed primarily of connective tissue that constitutes a gateway between the uterus and vagina. Okay, now. So this is the vagina. This is the uterus and vagina. So this is a gateway is there. One of the gateway like structure is the cervix is there. So like the rest of the reproductive tract, that cervix is lined with the mucosal cells. Okay. The mucosal cells, the cervix which should be made by mucosal cells. These cells make significant changes as the animal goes from one estrous cycle to another during the gestation or pregnancy, right? So these mucosal cells are present in the different mammals. The estrous cycle to maintain by these mucosal cells are there during the gestation and pregnancy, right? And next one, vagina. Next female reproductive system, the vagina. So this vagina, the vagina serve as the female organ of copulation at mating. So this vagina serve as a female organ for the copulation mating with the female with male. Okay, and as this vagina which is responsible for the parturition, but the birth, the baby should be delivered through the vagina. The birth canal or the parturition also. It is a passage between the cervix and the vulva. It is a passage, but cervix and the vulva. So it is there, one of the passages like is there. The lining is moist. The lining is moist during the estrus and dry when the animal is not in the estrus. Okay. When the animals are estrous cycle, they are here, they are in heat, it should be very wet in condition. So not in eustress, okay, it should be dry. Where the wet or moisture during the eustress, where the wet in a drying condition, there is the not eustress cycle. Okay, now. So this is what vagina importance, right? Next one, next to female reproductive part, that is bladder. Okay. Right, the bladder. The bladder collect the what is ma? The bladder collect the liquid waste. The bladder should collect the liquid waste which is called urine. The bladder should collect the liquid waste which is called what ma? Urine. The urine passes through the urethra to the vagina. Okay, so the urine process through the urethra to the vagina. That's why this bladder to observe the what ma? The waste material of the urine. Okay, should be observed from the urethra. So that is what a very important thing. And next one, female reproductive system, vulva. Okay, so this vulva is the external opening of the reproductive system. External opening of the reproductive system and urinary system. What is that, ma? External, the vulva is external opening of the reproductive system and urinary system. It should be exterior and visible part of the vulva. It consists of two folds called the labia majora and labia minora is there. Labia majora, two lip-like structure is there. That is labia majora, labia minora are the two folds located just inside of the labio majora. So this is what vulva is there. And female reproductive system, that is clitoris, is there. The clitoris is the sensory. The clitoris is what ma? Sensory and erectile organ. Clitoris is what ma? Is the sensory erectile organ of the female. It is located just inside of the vulva. Okay, so that is one of the important thing. So the female reproductive system in cow, see, in that. Okay, in that, see, we are observing in this reproductive system, what is my clitoris is there, vulva is there, urethra is there, and vagina is there, and cervix. Over cervix is the passage, and ovary is there, and oviduct also there. So these are the what ma total, that is female reproductive system in a cow. Okay, and next one. The dorsal view of the reproductive system in female cow, what is that? Okay, simply, what is that, ma? This is ovary, and uterine horn is there, and oviduct there. But uterine horn, in this uterine horn, fertilization takes place. The ovary should produce, okay, this is the funnel like is there, the ovary to produce ova and enters into uterine horn. In this uterine also, fertilization takes place, right? And body of the uterus, okay, and cervix looking like one thread like structure, cervix, and vagina also there. And this vagina open into vulva, and this vulva open into outside through the clitoris also there. This is the one of the important female reproductive system in cow. Female reproductive system EV. So EV, uterine horns are there, fallopian tube, cervix, body of the uterus, vagina, and vulva also there. And reproductive system and do. Okay. In this, what happened, ma? Uterus. Okay. A bladder. Uterus also called mother womb. Okay. Bladder is there. Vagina, vulva is also there. Okay. So in this, do also we are observing. Right. What are the major male and female reproductive organs in poultry and their function? Of course, the poultry is not required for in this. Okay, poultry is not essential for our syllabus. Okay. Next, we are going to discussing about what is atma? Gametogenesis. What is gametogenesis? Let us next topic is that is. What is that, ma? Gametogenesis. What is gametogenesis? It will be asking a long question. Okay. What is the gametogenesis process? Okay. The gametogenesis, the production of the gametes from the reproductive system is called what, ma? Gametogenesis. Okay, so that is now we are going to discussing the gametogenesis, including which contains spermatogenesis and oogenesis. In the influence of FSH and LH hormone also, what is gametogenesis? The process we are going to discussing about. So the process we are going to see. Gametogenesis means the production of the gametes from the gamete, production of the gametes from the reproductive system, reproductive organs, like the sperm, spermatozoa production from testes, and ova should be production from the oogonium. So in this, for the production of the egg, production of the ova is called oogenesis, production of the sperm is called what, ma? Spermatogenesis. I think developmental biology we already studied, right? What is that and the gametogenesis process? For example, in this gametogenesis, okay, oogonium, actually the oogonium which is a diploid stage, okay, so the oogonium which is a diploid stage, okay, this oogonium which is a multiply, okay, the in the this oogonium which is a diploid stage which is to multiply, that means double, it will be double takes place in the S phase, that is pre-meiotic phase. pre-meiotic stage in the that synthetic phase, okay, that develop the 2N should be converted into 4N. So in the meiotic M phase, this 4N, which is enters into what ma? That is oocyte maturation. So how that ma? These ova should be converted into primary oocyte. Primary oocyte, what happened ma? To send to form of what happened ma? The secondary oocyte and first polar body. So primary oocyte also, which is having which is a 4N state, from the primary oocyte to by the what ma? So meiosis, that is what ma? Meiosis one, two cells are produces. In the meiosis one, two cells are produces, that is secondary oocyte cells and first polar body also there. And then this primary oocyte goes to meiosis two. In that the case, the secondary primary oocyte convert into secondary oocyte. The secondary oocyte, what happened ma? To after meiotic division. So mainly what happened ma? So totally four, that means you know very well, mature oocytes also form and second polar body also form. From the secondary oocyte again goes to meiotic division two. So in that condition, mature oocytes are formed and the second polar body also form. Only one mature oocyte, remaining all are going to what? Polar bodies. The polar bodies are not which is responsible for the fusion of with the sperm, right? So these mature oocyte fertilize with the sperm to be form of what happened, ma? So zygote should be formed. So this is the case we are observing in the diagram. See, spermatogonium. Let us go to what, ma? Spermato. That is we are discussed oogenesis. Here the spermatogonium. The spermatogonium means what, ma? The huge amount of the spermatozoa. The spermatozoa which carries, which present so many seminiferous vesicles present in this part, that is called what, ma? Group of spermatozoa. That is called storage in the spermatogonium. The spermatogonium, which is present at testes, right? The spermatogonium also testes are deployed. Spermatogonium are deployed. Though before that process, the spermatogonium, which is goes to what ma? Mitotic division. So mitotic division, the synthetic phase, that not mitotic division, in the what ma? Interphase. So this spermatogonium interphase, it will be 2N to be the 2N should be doubled. That means 4N should be formed. That is called primary spermatocyte also formed. These primaries are primary spermatocytes. They are going to meiotic division 2. What ma? Meiotic division 2. That means the primary spermatocytes to produce it. What ma? Secondary spermatocytes are formed. The secondary spermatocytes also, which is having diploid state. Then these secondary spermatocytes, which are going to what happened ma? See, convert into spermatid. What ma? Convert into spermatid goes to meiotic division. Meiotic division 2. Meiotic division 2, meiotic division 1, that means secondary spermatocytes also form. And meiotic 2, this diploid state of secondary spermatocyte convert into sperm. That is spermatid. The spermatid develop into sperm. So this is called what happened ma? Spermatogenesis process. Spermatogenesis means production of the sperm from the sporia, that means what was spermatogonium or spermato. That is called spermatogenesis. Oogenesis means what ma? Just now already told you above the production of the ova from the oogonium. Production of the ova, oocyte from the oogonium is called oogenesis. After oogenesis, after spermatogenesis, what happened ma? Both are, the sperm enters into oviduct horn and ova also enters into this oviduct. In the fusion takes place, fertilization takes place, internal fertilization takes place, and then 2 to 4 days it will be entered, zygote enters into the uterus. This is called overview of gametogenesis. Now in detail we are going to see gametogenesis. What is gametogenesis in detail? We are going to see the gametogenesis means what? Formation of gametes. What ma? Formation of gametes is called what ma? Gametogenesis, right? How the gametes are formed, right? Gametes develop into the gonads, like sex cells, like testes, and that means verma ovaries, right? See, in male it is spermatogenesis form of sperm. That means what ma? In males formation of the sperm, okay, is called what ma? spermatogenesis. Okay, in a female, the formation of the ova is called oogenesis. Okay, we are observing in this in the diagram, spermatogonium and oogonium. Okay, in the spermatogonium, what are the phases, ma? Number one, growth phase and maturation phase. Number two, division phase. Okay, from the spermatogonium in the spermatogonium, the sperm cells the cells are going to growth and maturation takes place in the phase of FSH and LH. In the same phenomena, oogonium also there. From the spermatogonium to after mitotic division, primary spermatocytes also form. Here, primary oocytes also form in the female, right? And these primary spermatocytes, primary oocytes, which are takes place mitotic division. In the mitotic division, primary spermatocytes convert into secondary spermatocytes. In the same, primary oocyte convert into secondary oocytes, right? In the same phenomena, right? In the meiotic, these secondary spermatocytes goes to meiotic division 2, ultimate as well as same vice versa, secondary oocytes also going to what happened, ma? Enters into meiotic division 2. So here, remembering one thing, the secondary oocytes are all oocytes are enters into meiotic division 2 to be form of spermatids 4. Four spermatids also form. Whereas in secondary oocytes, after the secondary oocytes, what happened, ma? The primary, you remember one thing, primary oocyte is takes place of in meiotic division 2. In that the case, what happened, ma? So secondary oocyte form, first polar body should be formed. The secondary oocyte enters into meiotic division, what happened, ma? Oocyst, that means what, ma? Ootid form. Ootid means here which group of ova is formed. And secondary polar bodies are formed. Okay, na? Totally four polar bodies also formed, right? So three are secondary polar bodies, one is first polar body also formed. Okay, then this ootid enters into differentiation. Differentiation means from ootid means a group of ova is there. The ova is immature. This immature ova from ootid to outside, the differentiation to be formed of ova. Over. Okay, at the same time, the secondary spermatids enter into meiotic division 2 to form of four secondary spermatids into four spermatids also there. Spermatids means what happened, ma? Which contains a spermatozoa. These spermatids differentiation takes place to be form of spermatozoa. So this is important about this process takes place. Now in detail, spermatogenesis we are going to see. What is a spermatogenesis process, right? The process by which spermatogonia, the spermatogenesis means process by which spermatogonia differentiates into mature spermatozoa. The process by which spermatogonia differentiate into mature spermatozoa. That means in the spermatogonium, which is so many divisions, mitotic division, mitotic division first, meiotic division two, one and two. So first growth phase and maturation phase and next division phase and last differentiation phase. Finally, the spermatozoa is enters, right? Begins at puberty. So where the mammals are, they are enters in the puberty, this spermatogenesis process takes place. Before the puberty should not take place. Remembering one thing, the spermatozoa are formed. The spermatozoa are formed the wall of seminiferous tubule. When the seminiferous tubules of the testis, right? This is the spermatozoa formed in the wall of seminiferous tubules in the testis. Remembering one thing. See, for example, in this. Okay, so here we are observing. See, epididymis is there. That section of the epididymis, the section of the epididymis. What happened, ma? Seminiferous tubules are there in the testis. Epididymis. Testes are there, seminiferous tubules are there. The seminiferous tubules, which is a wall which contains a huge seminiferous cells are there. These seminiferous tubules, which are present in the diploid state in the spermatogonium. All the seminiferous tubules which are present in this gonium, that is called as spermatogonium. This spermatogonium is a diploid state. Spermatogonium also diploid state. This spermatogonium, which contains a huge number of spermatozoa, is there immature. This spermatogonium, which takes place mitotic division, to be produces primary spermatocytes. Okay, then primary spermatocytes takes place meiotic division one, and secondary oocytes also, secondary spermatocytes also form. The secondary spermatocytes takes place meiotic division two to be form of spermatids. The spermatid and differentiation to be form of sperm cells also form. We are observing this diagram, right? So this is important about spermatogenesis process. Okay, in this spermatogenesis, what are the steps that they are going to see? First, number one, many cells of the different sizes of the shapes, various cells stages in the spermatogenesis. Number two, that means Sertoli cells. Sertoli cells also there. The Sertoli cells provide the nutrient. That means it gives the nutrient to germ cells. The Sertoli cells to provide the nutrients. This provide support nutrition to the germ cells. Regulated by luteinizing hormone. Luteinizing hormone. It binds the leading cells to stimulate the testosterone production. These Sertoli cells to protect to produce nutrition to germ cells in the presence of luteinizing hormone. These cells to bind with the leading cells and the what happened? Testosterone to production takes place. These testosterone to develop the testes and the production of the spermatogenesis, which is responsible by the testosterone. For example, see A is the spermatogonia, B is the spermatogonia. So mitosis takes place and to form of spermatocytes, secondary sperma, primary spermatocytes, secondary spermatocytes, meiotic division after meiosis 2, 1, and spermatocytes 2 also form. After meiotic 2, the spermatocytes converted to spermatids. These spermatids, which is differentiation to be form of sperm. So this is the process of spermatogenesis. In the spermatogenesis, three stages are there. One is maturation phase. Okay, and second one is the division phase, third one differentiation phase, remembering one thing, right? So here, what is that, ma? What type of, so we are observing the spermatogenesis, like meiosis one. In the meiosis one, okay, the primary oocyte formed from spermatogonium by the mitotic division. This spermatocyte enters into primary spermatocyte enters into meiotic division to form of secondary oocytes. Secondary oocyte meiotic division 2 to form of spermatids. Spermatids, what happened? Comes outside, that is called the spermatogonia. Spermatozoa is formed, right? The process of transformation of the circular spermatid. The process of transformation of circular spermatid into spermatozoa is called spermiogenesis. Spermatogenesis is different from spermiogenesis, remembering one thing. So that is what, ma? The formation of sperm, the formation of sperm from the spermatogonium is called what, ma? Spermatogenesis, right? But spermiogenesis means the processing of production of the spermatozoa from spermatids is called what, ma? Spermiogenesis, remembering one thing. Simply, spermiogenesis means what, ma? So production of the spermatids or release of spermatozoa from spermatid is called spermiogenesis, simply, right? So in this, a Golgi phase takes place, co-op phase takes place, acrosomal phase takes place, maturation phase takes place in this spermatozoa. Okay, and the spermatozoan activity, right? What are the activities there? The activity of motile free swimming cell, it consists of the spermatozoa, head, neck and tail also there. In the head region, ovoid that is consist of nucleus, anterior one of the nucleus is there, and this head region which covered by acrosome also there. Acrosome also there. The tail has three segments, are the middle piece and principal also there. These are the three parts are there in the tail region. And now let us go to oogenesis also. Okay, what is that, ma? Oogenesis. Oogenesis occurs, remembering one thing, in the ovaries. In the oviducts also takes place. It starts before birth. Ovary has cortex and medulla. The oogonia present to cortex also there. The oogonia are produced at very early stage before birth. Do not multiply thereafter. Okay, now. So this is the oogenesis, means formation of the formation of ova, formation of eggs from the oogonium, simply. In this phase also, Remembering one thing. So this is a ovary. In this way, in this phase also, primordial germ cells are there. This is called the primordial germ cells, which are present in the oogonium. Which is present in the oogonium which contains primordial germ cells are there. So these oogonium which contains diploid state. So these oogonium takes place mitotic division to be form of primary oocyte. So and this primary oocyte takes place meiotic division 1 to be form of secondary oocyte and first polar body. What is it, ma'am? First polar body also form. Then next secondary oocyte enters into meiotic division 2 to be form of ovitid. Ovitid. So ovitid means what, ma? Ovid. Simple got ovid. It is also haploid states. Okay. Then form of again here the formed a secondary polar body also there. First polar body where the primary oocyte takes place meiotic division 1 to be form of secondary oocyte and first polar body also form. Then the secondary oocyte goes to meiotic division 2 form of ovid and secondary polar body also form. So this is what very important. Then what happened from the ovid, the process of processing of ova should form from the ovid. It is called what, ma? Oviogenesis, right? What is that, ma? Oviogenesis. This is called a process. So oogenesis takes place. In this oogenesis process, simply what, ma? Here primary oocyte after meiotic division, after mitotic division, primary oocyte should form. The primary oocyte enters into meiotic division 1, secondary oocyte and first polar body is formed. Secondary oocyte again enters in meiotic division 2, what ma? Secondary polar body and ootid should be formed. This ootid or ovid, whatever you mean, this ootid convert into formation of ova. So this is called oogenesis. After telophase 1 and 2, the cytoplasm is not equally divided. One of the new cell gets majority survives while the one is polar bodies formed. What is ma? Polar bodies formed. This is the diagram of oogenesis, oogonium diploid state, mitosis division, and to be form of two oogonias are formed. Oogonium is converted into two oogonia. Oogonia also diploid state. These oogonia to form of growth and differentiation, growth phase and maturation phase. Then it will be go to meiotic division to be form of primary oocyte 1. Primary oocyte before the birth, primary oocyte takes place of meiotic division 1 and to be formed first polar body and secondary oocyte. The secondary oocyte which is also haploid state. The secondary oocyte takes place meiotic division 2 to be form of 4. So one pure ovum should be formed and second polar body is formed. So here this ovum from formed from ootid to oogonium, so that is called oviogenesis. This is the process production of the ovum. So these ovum get ready for fusion with the sperm, right? And the spermatogenesis, right? Here we are seeing a diagram, same similar diagram. Remembering one thing, what is the diagram? Spermatogenesis and oogenesis. Spermatogenesis from the spermatogonia to spermatogonium to spermatogonia diploid state, spermatogonia to mitotic division, primary oocyte, primary spermatocytes form. Same oogenesis, oogonia to primary oocyte. Okay, the primary spermatocyte, primary oocyte enters into meiotic division 1, enters into form of secondary oocyte and polar body also form. Whereas primary spermatocyte enters into meiotic division 1, secondary spermatocytes also form. Two are formed. Whereas in primary oocyte enters into meiotic division, only one secondary oocyte is formed, one polar body is formed, right? Remember one thing, okay now. Then the secondary spermatocytes enters into meiotic division to form of four spermatids, haploid spermatids also form. In the same manner, secondary oocyte enters into meiotic division to only haploid state of ootids formed, okay? Three secondary polar bodies are formed, what ma? Three secondary polar bodies also formed. So that is what very important. From spermatid to spermatova, differentiation takes place. What happened? Spermatozoa is formed. Same ootid to ovum by the differentiation process takes place. Here, what are the stages? Ma? Growth and the maturation phase, division phase, and what ma? Differentiation phase. This is the process takes place Okay, spermatogenesis and oogenesis process. So it will be asking compulsory reproductive system, the mammalian reproductive system and the gametogenesis. Compulsory will asking a long question from animal biotechnology. So this is a one of the important question. Okay, I would like to send PDF also. Don't bother about that. Okay, thank you very much. Today the session is completed. So this is Krishna sir. So your geology. So don't miss it. Tomorrow also I will take Martin class. Okay now, so don't miss it because of your exam is Monday, I think. Okay, that's why you must be listen tomorrow and Sunday class. Okay, just 1.5 hour, 1.5 hour class. Thank you very much. So this is Krishna sir signing out. Thank you, thank you. Any doubt? No doubt. Okay, thank you Pallavi, thank you everyone, thank you Sai Chandana, Shiva Shankar, Hina, Vaishnavi, thank you ma, thank you very much.